Okay, so to set up my new months, what I do is I kind of have my planner open to the month that comes next, or the section that would come first. If I'm liking it in this order, that's the way that I'm going to pull it. Or you can kind of do the same thing and then later on, once you've pulled everything, you can reorganize it. But so I have my planner open to the current month. And this is my home or catch-all planner section. So I like to use the Homebody seasonal. So what I'm going to do is pull out the next month, which will be March. And I'm going to go ahead and pull out all of March. In the past, I may not have pulled out every single week of that month, but I'm pretty positive I will be using this the way that I have been using it all month. And then what I'm going to do is just kind of set that to the side over here. Now when I insert these and take February out, February will go there. So these are just going to kind of go in a little pile upside down over here on my desk. That planner gets put to the side, and then the next section, I'm not going to move it back and forth every time, but the next section that I have within my catch-all is my home here, and I will have to change this out a little bit later because it's really just my monthly section, and I might end up having to change that out. We will see, but I am not going to pull out anything for my home section yet. These are all just a couple or a few different pages that are going to be inserted into my home planner, which is these ones, and I'm not even using them right now at this moment. So I'm going to pull them out of my current planner and put them there with February's catch-all section. And I will decide whether I want to do a whole monthly spread for my catch-all, because what I typically do with this one is my meals. I feel like combining them, it gets a little bit busy, and I'm not sure if I really want to do that. So plus I like the look of the monthlies. Okay, so my next section is my wellness. So my wellness planner, I'm really still enjoying using this planner for my wellness. So what I'm going to do is go to the next section. Oh, I love this one. And I will pull this out and add that to my March pile. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll take out 5 just in case. It does seem to be a little bit of a longer month. So then I'm going to lay those upside down there. Switch this over. And my next one, as you can see here, is my faith. Okay, there's that so far, and now for my budget. Okay. So in the beginning of my budget, I have a lot of extra papers from the Budget Mom or any other printouts that I need to keep. And it looks like this is where I took from last, so I'm going to go ahead and grab this next set. So that is where I'm at for setting up what I need in March. Now, it's kind of a tricky time because I am nowhere near March. I still have a week and a half or two left of February, but I wanted to show you guys how I get prepared for the next month. And I'm not usually adding this much to my planner during the middle of the month. I just don't want that. So what I'm going to do is just kind of go through each page, see if there's anything that I can have time to or want to set up right now, look ahead at what's going on in the month, and maybe just start doing some kind of labeling or to-do lists that I know I need to do. So technically, this is my, let me see if I could get some kind of shot of all of this for you guys. So I can't get it all. That's okay. But what I do is I go back through and see if that's something I want to reuse it as. So before, I was using this as mainly just meal planning, meal inspiration, cooking inspiration, and all that. And I really do like that idea. I have, as you can see, we're only halfway through the month, but I have pretty much put all our meals in there. I score them based on whether I want to make it again for us, maybe make it again, and definitely make it again. So I really, really do like that. So what I'm going to do is, since I'm going to be reusing it this way, I'm going to try to figure out for some special things going on what we're going to be doing then for meals. Okay, so that is going to be my March setup for the calendar anyway. We have the inside, we have some of my home information there. Now, these end up being my catch-all, like everything. So anything that's going on in all my other sections, the main things I need to get done are here, and then I put my little section set up here. I have a video almost ready to go for you guys about how I set up my home section or my catch-all section. And I'm hoping it's either out there for you already, and if it is, I'll link it below. If it's not, it's coming out really soon, okay? So that way you guys can see how I set that up every week, because it's a system that I'm loving right now. And of course, if something changes, I'll share it, but that's something what I'm doing right now. I kind of can look ahead. So again, another thing happening at the beginning of next month. Keep that in mind. I probably should write that in right here.